art. I actually always studied art, even when I was younger. Art classes were my favorite. They were the classes I felt that I could be more successful in, and so I gravitated towards those art classes. And having my first experience at the Smithsonian and going to see this huge art, watermelon paintings at the Smithsonian, and just being completely immersed in one of those paintings was like magic to me. And also having a family member. She used to be a watercolorist, and she moved from that to making these constructions out of found objects, which I also found very magical. So that was my first experience with art making, and it was something that planted the seed within me that I can also be an artist. So I went to school, and I thought I had to be more academic. I thought I could be an art historian, but I didn't know that I could make it as an artist. But I started taking art classes. So you have to take painting and drawing and all of that to be a major, an art history major. So as I was taking those art classes, it became more apparent to me that that's what I should be doing, because I was an artist. I took everything from drawing to painting to stucco painting to that I became a studio major. Except there was a pivotal point in my life where I had to make that decision, and so I majored in studio art. And fast forward to 2 years later, actually 20 years later, during the pandemic, I had some major life changes happen to me, and we all did. These things that were just going on at the same time, but I was offered a second chance to bring out these paintbrushes again and paint. I had become a leatherer before, I had worked in an art museum, worked in the arts, and I painted here and there, but I was really never, I just didn't really get an art show together until recently. And 2 years ago, I brought out my paintbrushes. Some canvases, I didn't care how much they cost, I didn't care how deep, I just set up a little space in my studio down in the basement, and I started painting again, and all this stuff started coming out. I started getting, wild about color again. Some of the pieces that I had painted before were kind of dark and kind of like somewhat melancholy, which, could have been stuff that was going on in my life. And everything started to get brighter again. I started bringing the light and the color that is within me onto the canvas. And I kept painting one after another, and it just kept going until I had enough to put together an online portfolio. And on that online portfolio, I started to see there were themes. Like, there were themes like, landscape themes, and there were some themes about inspirations, people that inspired me during this whole time. People I shared my art with, and so I put that in there. And then I eventually saw that I had this large body of work and started showing people. And I put it on my Facebook, put it on LinkedIn, and I was like, this is what I've been doing. And people started responding to it. I'm telling you this story because I want you to know that it just didn't happen like overnight. It was something that had been developed for a long time. Within me, but I just didn't put it together. So the themes that I have in my artwork in here are dreamscapes, because through that time I had been traveling and we couldn't do anything indoors, so what I could do is be inspired by the outdoors by going hiking. And so I took a trip to Santa Fe. I just got the car one weekend, so I want to go. I've never been. Someone told me it was wonderful, and so I got in the car. I went and I walked around, ate food, enjoyed the color, the culture, the art galleries, and I was inspired by that. I was inspired by the landscape of getting in that car and just driving from South Colorado all the way through New Mexico, and I was just captivated. captivated by that landscape and taking it all in. And so what came out of that is the works that you see in here. One of my pieces, this is Sankin Wat 2. This was taken after I just walked around the whole city. Even if I went to like the same place, I went to the George O'Keeffe Museum. I went to visit all these different places and tried to take in the architecture and the landscape that was surrounding me. And all these colors started to infuse into my vision. And so when I got back, I took about a month or two off to kind of like start a job. I had to kind of let this stuff kind of settle within me. And I bought some panels. And I started putting all this stuff together, all these sights and sounds and feelings that I was feeling when I went to travel to these places. And I worked with oil very early on, but I felt like acrylic is something that I wanted to work with because it dries faster and I can layer and I can really enjoy, you know, that process. So a lot of these colors have to do with some you can't get with oil paint. Some of them are very, very electric. And I'm very attracted to adding this pops of color in because they evoke a feeling. They evoke something that, you know, if you've ever been someplace and you've seen something and you know, have that moment, that's where these colors are coming from. So, and just really exploring the textures of those colors too. So that's what comes out of it. My later works have to do with exploring landscapes and abstracting them. I jumped in the abstract very early on. I love the drawing and painting classes where you have to draw from a model and you have to do like very basic line drawings, but I was very inspired by some of the abstract expressionists, George O'Keeffe. Helen Frankenthaler is one of my favorite artists of all time. She's amazing, like the washes of color that she creates. Another word, I can't describe it, but it's magical to me. So that resonates with me when I'm painting. So that's one of them. That's Canyon Walk Through the Canyons. And if you've ever walked through any of the landscapes, either Red Rocks or anything in Colorado, you're gonna see all these amazing lines and all these connections. And so that's what I was trying to do there, trying to draw that in together.